My name is Thao Ha. I am an assistant professor here in the Department of Psychology at Arizona State University. And my lab's name is the At Heart Lab, which stands for At Healthy Experiences Across Relationships and Transitions. So yesterday I was invited to give a presentation for the Hispanic Mother-Daughter program, which is an incredible program in which they prepare it's called mother-daughter, but they also actually have sons there and fathers are there too. And it's a program that for high school students to prepare them for the transition to college, to ASU, and they get a lot of information over the course of 2 years. And my presentation was at the end, so this was the last session yesterday. And the room was filled with these wonderful parents and teenagers. There were like 500 or 1,000 of them. And so the topic that I talked about yesterday was healthy relationships and kind of trying to respectfully plant a seed that relationships are actually really important to consider for academic achievement and academic engagement, because we prepare these first generation students in terms of like healthy lifestyle, studying, mentoring, and all the academic stuff. But then we actually forget the one and only thing that is actually probably a lot on their minds when they're in college, which is dating. And also acknowledging that I know that some parents really don't want their children to date or really are against it, or they just don't want to know about it. So my take home message was try to talk to your children about their dating experience, because you want to be there when they get in trouble. Approximately like 80% of teenagers by the age of 18 have dated. 92% has been in love. So it's really irrespective of religion or parental rules, it's a hot topic during adolescence. So my point was you can't really ignore it, because it's there. I try to explain how romantic relationship experiences, especially the stressful ones, can actually distract from academic engagement. And it goes through having very negative relationship experiences, such as breakups or fights, feelings of jealousy, not knowing how to cope with a breakup, keep thinking about your ex and things like that, that are absolutely destructive of school, because it can lead to feelings of depression. It's been found to be a predictor of suicide. It can lead to drinking. And so these are all factors that are destructive of school engagement. So I talked about those topics to kind of make the case that it is an influential socialization context that they should pay attention to. But I also wanted to make sure that parents realize that romantic relationships can also be a buffer for any of these outcomes. So students here at ASU, in especially long-term committed relationships, indicate that their partner is the most important source for support, social support. So that's really important to acknowledge as well, that when things actually go well, that it is a buffer against all of these bad outcomes that I just mentioned. So I was actually suggesting for them to talk, and I gave them some tips of how you can talk to your children about this, despite the fact that it's awkward and very sensitive for both parties. So I gave them some tips of like, just ask open questions, be supportive, and realize that these conversations are never perfect, but that it is important that it happens.